Yeah, this is the Midtown Learning Farm. We're part of the Cleveland Botanical Garden Green Corps program.
We're right here at the Dunham Tavern on Euclid Avenue. And what are we doing this morning?
This morning we're sifting compost. We've got three beds in progress here, or three bins of compost. Least finished, finished, and then this is going to be where we dump our brand new, newly pulled weeds here. So we turn it, we water it, we hope it gets sunlight, and we'll be able to use it on our garden beds, these beds and everywhere else. We'll put our beds to sleep this fall, we'll put compost down, we'll cover them up, and they'll be ready for the spring. So we're just sifting all the rocks and all the sticks out. Sometimes some string and other trash gets in there, so we want to make sure that doesn't end up in the garden beds. And that looks pretty good. We don't want it to be too heavy, so you can take that. You can just go around this way by the herb spiral.
We need, I think we're done with the two beds in the back, though. They're filled. If you want to double check, they could maybe use, actually they could use a little.
Yeah, we'll put more. Add more compost.
Always need more
compost. Always need more compost.
So add more to the two?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's all right. Yep. There. Over that next little bump.
Can you give us your name?
Oh, my name's Shanna. I'm a first year here.
Yeah.
And I like it. And I like it.
Good. So students get to work here from late spring until early fall, and this is their summer job. They get paid, they learn all aspects of urban farming, from growing, weeding, working the farmers markets. They really get a start to finish learning process of how to farm in the city. So what's your favorite part of Green Corps, do you think?
My favorite is harvesting and markets, because I really like learning the customer relations and all that. But then also I really like harvesting, because it's like that final step that you did all that work and now you get this beautiful produce.
Right.
Do you plan on going into permaculture as a career?
I actually am very interested in environmental sciences, so that's what I'm thinking of majoring in, which kind of relates to gardening. And I garden at home, I have my own bed at home, so maybe not as a job, but definitely I think it's an interest of mine for the rest of my life.
Good. That's part of our goal.
So how do you recruit your students, Beth?
We send out applications to local schools, mostly CMSD schools, and we want students that apply to be able to...
Tell us what CMSD is.
Oh, Cleveland Metropolitan School District, so we give them applications.
For the high school.
Right, they send them back in the late winter. We start selecting applications. They'll go through an interview process. Just for this farm alone, the Midtown Farm, we had almost 60 applications, and I think there were just 10 spots to fill. So it's pretty selective. Students have to want to be here, want to learn about gardening.
How long does the program last?
First-year students start in early June, and the program ends at the end of October.
Oh, so they just like to spend like this 1 year of their high school experience.
The students have the opportunity to work three seasons, so it's really great when a student can do 3 years, because then they get to learn all about, they get special projects, they get to help install school gardens. So if everything goes well for them during their first year or their second year, they've got the opportunity to stick around for 3 years. So.
I think we have a question.
Where's the compost going?
I think it needs to go in the herb spiral because...
Yeah.
Because ours is full back there.
Okay, probably two or so on the herb spiral.
Okay.
We'll find another place for it. It can all use compost. Right. Well, they're doing more. They're planting the marigolds back there. They're weeding today, so a lot more footage.
I could take a look. Yeah, I should go over, follow them, I guess.
All right. Thanks, Jim.
Thank you, Beth.
Can't wait to see how it turns out.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
I love this compost. It makes us look terrifying.
you notice all the beautiful collards, greens, and cabbages, the green leafy vegetables that they have here at the urban farm. Can I get your name?
Honesty.
Hi, Honesty. What school do you attend?
John Hay.
Oh, so what happens? You come over during the mornings, or how does it work?
I start school in August.
Oh, okay. So you're like a junior high school student, like?
High school.
You're high school?
Ninth grade.
Ninth grade, okay. Oh, you're out for summer now?
Uh-huh.
Oh, great. I see what you mean, yeah. And what's your name?
TJ.
Hi, TJ. What school do you attend?
I go to Clean Station Catholic.
Oh, that's wonderful, yes. I have to stop by. I'm with Fatima, our St. Agnes Lady of Fatima Church in this community, in the health area, and they have a community garden, and you just reminded me I have to stop by there and see how their garden is coming this summer. I know this is the spiral herb garden,
yeah.
And you all got some more of the compost, and I saw you sifting it.
Huh?
Your name is?
TJ.
Yeah, TJ. Just that quick after. TJ.
No.
Oh, no.
TJ. Like the SH.
Like TJ?
It's in French.
Okay, yeah. French. Yeah, like TJ. What does it mean?
Oh,
it's a beautiful name.
Wonderful name. I really don't know what it means, but it's my mom just came up with me.
That's a wonderful idea. And we have this garden, and I saw you sifting this compost. Why it's so fine and so enriched looking. The whole idea about the spiral garden, folks, is that the water, as it rains, comes down on the plants on top, and then the water drains down in a spiral to the bottom. So, TJ, what got you interested in working in gardens?
Well, my auntie, she was at the Botanical Gardens and she wanted me to work in.
Are you enjoying the summer?
Yes.
Wonderful. Thanks for your interview. And here we have a beautiful sunflower. And we see all these beautiful, well-organized plants. So vibrant and lush here. We have some parsley. Kale. We also have flowers here as well. We see that these are some what is that called? This flower here. I can't think of it on the tip of my tongue. My grandmother grew these in her yard. So what's your name?
Nia.
Well, hi, Nia. You're with the Cleveland Botanical Garden.
Yes.
And what school do you attend?
Beaumont.
Oh, Beaumont School for Girls.
Yes.
Fabulous choice. How do you enjoy your summer this summer?
I like it. It's pretty fun.
Why did you make the Botanical Gardens your choice?
I like nature.
Oh, wonderful. Do you have a garden at home?
No, I don't.
Mm-hmm. Well, do you think you always, did you will at some point?
I will, after, now that I know how to
grow. Would you like to make it a career, permaculture?
Maybe as like a side career. Well, like.
What are you interested in? What's going to be your major?
What's business.
Your, oh, business, yes. Well, you know, the business of farming is important for the sustainability of our neighborhoods and our community. Gladiolas. I'm glad I remembered, I looked at you, I thought of, yeah, gladiolas, that's what this is for. Yeah. Here's some more. And so much to see here at this urban farm that we'll have to make sure that we stop again to make another visit. They have corn. Here's the corn. Hi, Flo Nickerson.
Hello, how
are you? You're the director here.
Good to see you.
Wonderful. Can you tell us a little bit about the garden?
Of course. This is green core. Has anyone talked to you about green core?
Beth was telling me a little bit.
Okay. Well, we have our students here that we're doing. Actually, we had an opportunity to talk to Miss Annie. It was on 66th Street.
Yeah, Annie.
And
Brownie.
She has a big garden. I think it's 66th Street. Anyway, she's got a big garden over there. And so we had a benefit today. She told us to come over and get some of her marigolds, and we're putting them in our garden because we know that marigolds are a good ground cover. It keeps out the weeds, and it keeps away the insects.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
So that's what Eva's doing over there.
Because you see the leaves, when those tomato caterpillars taste those leaves, they just, it's so distasteful to them that they just immediately leave your garden.
Right, right. So yeah, we have our teenagers that come here, and this is their summer job. They love it here.
And your name is?
Hello, I'm Eva.
And what school do you attend?
I graduated from the Cleveland School of the Arts.
Oh, that's wonderful, Cleveland Municipal School District.
Yep.
Great.
What will you be going in the fall?
I'll be going to CASE for cognitive science and maybe minoring in German.
That's fabulous. Yeah. That's very good.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yes, we do some videos with Case Western Reserve University.
Okay.
And we do a lot of their volunteers, and we work with the, on this end of this video will be a feature, the Masters in Public Health is a recommended video after they see this video.
Okay. Awesome.
And great students, they all in permaculture, and they all have their hands dirty,
right.
And everybody's out there digging. And
we're all happy.
Weeding, yes, absolutely, Flo.
It just feels good.
Oh, God, wonderful. I'm glad you had such an early start in your life to dedicate yourself to... Do your parents have a garden, or did you have any other experience as a gardener?
My mom and my grandmother did, and then ours kind of went under for a little bit. But this year, my mom and I rebuilt our garden, so I'm really excited about that.
That's wonderful. And you're going to be staying locally here to go to CASE. You're going to just love it. Well, you have a pleasant day.
Thank you. You too.